trade union structure was to be developed so that it could serve better political purposes of the CIA.
The CIA and other arms of imperialism are using destabilization in Grenada and in the Caribbean even today. In the 1960s, during the Chedi-Jagan government in Guyana, a series of fires were set, accompanied by unexplained strikes and industrial unrest, which later proved to be the work of the CIA. The Grenada International Travel Service and one of the tourist cottages were burned to the ground in a coordinated action on May 6, thus marking the beginning of violent destabilization in our country. The fires threatened tourism, one of our major industries, destroying travel documents and causing adverse publicity abroad about the stability of our country. 5 months later, the American government openly announced a military program geared towards intimidation of progressive governments in the Caribbean.
I'm establishing a permanent, full-time Caribbean Joint Task Force headquarters at Key West, Florida. I will assign to this headquarters forces from all the military services responsible for expanded planning and for conducting exercises. This headquarters unit will employ designated forces for action if required. This will substantially improve our capability to monitor and to respond rapidly to any attempted military encroachment in this region. We will expand military maneuvers in the region. We will conduct these exercises regularly from now on. In accordance with existing treaty rights, the United States will, of course, keep our forces in Guantanamo. The United States has a worldwide interest in peace and stability. Accordingly, I have directed the Secretary of Defense to further enhance the capacity of our rapid deployment forces to protect our own interests and to act in response to requests for help from our allies and friends. We must be able to move our ground, sea, and air units to distant areas rapidly and with adequate supplies. These steps reflect my determination to preserve peace, to strengthen our alliances, and to defend the interests of the United States.
We believe that this is a reaction to the recent progressive changes and developments within the Latin American and Caribbean region. A wind of change is blowing through the Caribbean, bringing with it a new regional balance of forces as a result of the changes towards progress by the peoples of Nicaragua, Grenada, St. Lucia, and Dominica. A situation that has led the U.S. Secretary of State to define the Eastern Caribbean as being one of the world's four trouble spots. It is our view that a new regional balance of forces has serious implications for the profits being made by the multinational corporations and also has implications for geopolitical reasons in the region. And this is what is making reactionary elements in the United States desperate. The international community must take this new threat to the region seriously, because the U.S. government has an established pattern of using gunboat diplomacy, blockades, destabilization tactics, and other Cold War measures against the peoples of Latin America and the Caribbean. It is an attempt to revive the Monroe Doctrine, under which the United States claims the unilateral right to intervene militarily in the domestic affairs of any country in the region. And it is a matter of historical record that such interventions took place, among others, in Dominican Republic, in Haiti, in Guatemala, Colombia, Mexico, Nicaragua, and the very Cuba that today they are expressing so much hostility towards. For our part, we uphold the democratic right of the people of the Caribbean to choose their own government or political system. The Caribbean belongs to the peoples of the Caribbean. We reject the U.S. plan to set up a Caribbean task force, and we call upon the international community to join with us in demanding an immediate withdrawal of this proposal. We join also with our sister Caribbean nations in re-emphasizing our determination to preserve the Caribbean as a zone of peace, free from military intimidation.
This is an open letter to you, President Jimmy Carter, and it's in reference to the human rights matter. You cried out love for human rights for all mankind, but retreated as soon as the world replied. If we must lay to rest this grave human rights issue, you must face up to what the world has asked of you. They ask that you give every American equal human rights. Oh, you ask all leaders to give their people human rights. I represent America as a human rights ambassador, but before I take such a vote, you have to clear your own idea.
The U.S. human rights policy is not upheld when it comes to progressive governments. It was revealed in the U.S. Senate that even the economic human rights of Cuba were violated when their sugar crops were repeatedly destroyed in the early 1960s by the CIA. Also, bags of flour coming into the Caribbean seaports were known to have been poisoned by the CIA. In Guyana in the 1960s, and in Jamaica in 1975, flour was contaminated with the deadly poison parathion, causing numerous deaths. None of this has happened in Grenada to date, but since we import all our sugar and flour, it is absolutely necessary that our workers maintain constant vigilance against this method of destabilization.
It's time you give we blacks our human rights. Over 300 days and we still ain't got human rights.
We have discovered from talking to our fellow dock workers, one spent a long, long time being trained by the CIA in America. Every course they have, he take it.
Well, if you have any such among the workers, could be one or two, not much. Because 95% of the workers is heavily behind the government, right? So we see this revolution going to be a success. There's no way. I see there's no way that we could turn back, especially from the dark side. Everybody's fighting hard against the destabilizers who intend to turn it back.
Trade union infiltration and sabotage are two methods used against our revolution. Media subversion is another. Bernard Code addressed this issue.
There is one man in the Caribbean who is a shareholder and a director of the Trinidad Express, the Trinidad Sun, the Grenada Torchlight, the Barbados Nation, the Barbados Sunday Sun, Barbados Radio Rediffusion, and the chairman of the board of Bright O'Connor, putting out all that garbage in all the islands, in every radio station and newspaper. One man. So when you think you're hearing a lot of different people talking, is one man you hear talking. And that man wrote an editorial in the Express a few weeks ago in which he openly called for the violent overthrow of the Grenada government.
In relation to the torchlights, we were saying we are even willing to accept malicious and lying and destructive criticism that was not based on facts.
the kind of criticism that was taking rubbish and garbage out of overseas newspapers, where they were talking about how we cut down forests and we have missiles aimed at other islands, where they were talking about Russian naval bases in Carico. Even that kind of destructive criticism we are willing to put up with, because we felt the revolution was strong enough. But the one thing we can put up with from nobody is when they move to a stage to actively begin to incite violence, to actively begin to make counter-revolution. And that is why, following the Rasta's article on the Wednesday torchlight, we had to move on the torchlight right away. They're even inviting the Rastas to go out and demonstrate for their rights. Can you imagine that? Torchlight newspaper.
And the things that they had portrayed in the torchlight was just blatant lies, right? Just trying to cause conflict. Certain members of the 12th tribe who didn't know anything about that article, when they read it in the torchlight and see what it was leading to, came out and said that they dissociate themselves with this statement being issued in the torchlight by Rasta Jojo and Nang Nang, because they have no right, because it's 12 tribe and there are only two. So where are the other 10? It's the majority rule, and the majority have to take the rule.
Yeah, you know, over radio station that dread overthrow by the damn by revolution.
It's true, I dread Laksa, not your can't come and say. Long live Grenada, dread. Long live our revolution.
Long
live our PRL.
Now, what we see clearly is that just CIA at work. They know for sure that the Rastafarian is the poorest and the most frustrated people in the country today. No work for them and this type of thing, because of the class consciousness of the people. They still see Rasta as outcasts and not as human beings as they are. So, torchlight seeing that, and CIA is wise enough to see that too. And because of some differences and things that have been going on, they try to use the Rastas in trying to stir up counter-revolutionary actions within our country. So what we have to do today is to look carefully and see why they are trying to use the Rastafarian. Because the Rastafarian lack the clarity of what exactly is going on, and they was not conscious that they were being used by CIA.
Because I, man, stand firm to the, I mean, the beside of the working class. Because one day that dollar must die.
As a soldier attached to the Pulse unit, I understand what I'm defending. And since it is so, I must be able to understand the other struggle in different parts of the world.